Hey everybody, Dr. Schultz from the Centeno-Schultz Clinic. We're continuing our series on the thoracic spine, and today we're going to be talking about a thoracic cyst. That's right, a thoracic cyst. You or a loved one may get an MRI report, and it can say this: what in the world is this thoracic cyst, and what can we do about it? So thanks for checking in, and let's get started. So the goals of this presentation are to explain what in the world is that thoracic spine, what is a cyst in terms of the thoracic spine, and what are the four major types of thoracic spine cysts. So here we go. So the thoracic spine is that section of the spine that's below the neck and above the low back. It's that middle section which is depicted here. Sometimes people even refer to it as the mid-back, but it's a very, very important section of the thoracic spine that is often dismissed and is poorly understood. So thanks for taking the time to check in today. So what in the world is a cyst? It's an abnormal closed sac that contains different material. It can be a fluid, a gas, or a semi-fluid material. It can either be benign or malignant, that means cancerous. And they can be all throughout the body. They can be in different sizes, but what we're going to be focusing on today is those cysts that occur in the thoracic spine. So a thoracic spine cyst is an abnormal fluid collection that occurs in the thoracic spine. And there's four major types of cysts that you need to know about. And they include the synovial cyst, a vertebral body cyst, a perineural cyst, and a spinal cord cyst. Four really important types of cysts. So number one, a synovial cyst. They can be all throughout the body, but in this presentation, in terms of the thoracic spine, we're going to talk about that. They also are referred to many times as a ganglion cyst. They form near tendons, but they also can form near a joint. And in the thoracic spine, they typically occur in the facet joint. That's right, F-A-C-E-T. And they occur typically as a result of degeneration. And here's a great image. This is a cross section of the spine. And so this is the vertebral body here. So this is the front and this is the back. And these are the facet joints. And what you can see right here is this little fluid-filled cyst. And it is a synovial cyst that is coming out of this thoracic facet. That's the first type, synovial cyst, otherwise known as ganglion cyst. The second type is that type of cyst that occurs in the vertebral body. Now, as you remember, the vertebral bodies are those bony building blocks that stack one on top of the other. And here's a picture here, and here's one of the bony building blocks. And they're numbered in the thoracic spine, and for that matter, throughout the spine. And they are T1, 2, 3, all the way down to 12. So what in the world is a vertebral body cyst? It's simply a fluid-filled sac within the vertebral body. And you can see it here. This is a fluid-filled sac actually in the vertebral body. The third type of cyst in the thoracic spine is known as a perineural cyst. Peri means around, neural means nerve. So a perineural cyst is a cyst that forms around or within a nerve. It's also known as a Talhoff cyst. And you can see this depicted here. This is an axial image. This is the front, and this is the back, and this is the vertebral body, and this is the spinous process. This is the spinal cord. And from the spinal cord, a nerve has to exit on each side. But you can see this fluid-filled sac here. This is along the nerve. So this is a perineural cyst of the spine. And then this is an image from the front. This is actually the cervical spine. And you can see as the nerve comes out, it's fluid filled. So the third type of cyst for the thoracic spine is a perineural cyst, basically a cyst that forms around or in the nerve. And then the fourth one is known as a syrinx. So a syrinx is a rare neurological disorder. It's actually a cyst within the spinal cord, and oftentimes it extends. And here's an image. This is a side view. Again, here's the bony building block that stacks one on top of the other. And then you can see is the wafer or the shock absorber known as the disc. So this is the front, and this is the back. And here's the spinal cord. And lo and behold, what you see is a fluid-filled cyst here. And this is the fourth type of cyst in the thoracic spine, otherwise known as syrinx. So in terms of the thoracic spine, there are four major types of cysts: a synovial, a vertebral body, a perineural, and a spinal cord cyst. And the symptoms of each will vary depending upon the location, the size, and whether or not adjacent tissue is being compressed or irritated. If you or a loved one have ongoing thoracic pain that appears to be a mystery and is only being medicated with either narcotics or other medications, why don't you consider giving us a call where you'll get a board-certified fellowship physician who can evaluate potential sources of pain in the thoracic spine. Life is short. I hope this was helpful. Again, there are four different types of thoracic cysts, which we reviewed today. Thanks for taking the time to check in, and I'll see you next week.